And joining us now is the new captain of the New York Islanders, Anders Lee. And Anders, was it different last night as you led your team out in that game against the Carolina Hurricanes? Was it different for you in preparation as the captain now as opposed to being just another part of the team?
Absolutely. I think I found out in the morning that between meetings, Barry kind of announced it to the team. So, you know, I had a lot of stuff going on in the afternoon, a lot of congratulations coming in, and obviously I understand what comes with the territory. So a little bit more on my mind, but it was exciting. It was a fun game, and nice to start out on the right foot there with a little OT win.
Did I hear that correctly, Anders? It's Brian Lawton. Did you find out yesterday morning, or did you know earlier? And how did that feel when you heard it? Because I was an assistant captain in the National Hockey League, but to be a captain, what an incredible honor.
It really is. And, yeah, I had no idea. You know, it was just one of those things where you just go through camp, do your thing. And, you know, Barry came on and talked and spoke to the guys and announced the assistant captains and announced me. And, you know, it's such an honor. I was kind of overwhelmed with emotions a little bit and you know, just try to soak it in and enjoy it. But obviously it's a game day, so we had work to do, too, at the same time.
How would you describe your leadership style as you move into this new role?
You know, I think I'm, you know, one of those guys that obviously takes pride in going up and showing up every day to work hard and kind of doing a little bit of the little things. But, you know, I kind of like to keep things light, get all the boys involved and just kind of, I guess, around the room and enjoying what we have as a team. You know, vocal at times, but not really one of those hoorah guys. And, you know, just a regular guy in the locker room that guys can turn to, I guess, or anything like that. But, you know, I've always just kind of been myself and let those things kind of fall into place.
Okay, you're 1-0 now as a captain. Give us your grade of how it went last night. Obviously, the Carolina Hurricanes played very well. They had a lot to prove. New coach also, first-time coach in Brenda Moore. But what were your thoughts on the first game of really what should be a new era for the New York Islanders?
Yeah, you know what? I think last night we were a little bit sloppy, and Carolina kind of had a few waves of some good shifts and stuff throughout the game. And Greiser absolutely backed us up last night and kind of stole the game a little bit. But, you know, for the most part, we stuck with it, stuck with our game plan, and kind of battled out a gritty little 2-point win on the road. And, you know, you'd rather start with a win, but I think obviously we know we have better in the tank for sure.
Anders, you come into a situation this year, obviously a lot of things are different. Most namely, you have a new head coach in Barry Trotz, has a lot of experience coaching in this league. You have Lou Lamoriello, who's been around for seemingly forever in the National Hockey League, and he brings a distinct style. I know it's different with those two guys really at the helm leading things, but can you give me an example or two or how things are different for you and your teammates with Trotz and Lamoriello at the helm?
Yeah, with Barry and Lou and, you know, obviously their success and resume speak for themselves, but just their presence around our organization and around the guys, just it sets a tone and a culture of community and, you know, everyone that's buying in and taking pride in what it is to be an Islander and you know, the hard work and focus that we've put in through camp. It's just there's a different feel. There's an excitement around our room and around our rink that it's been really extremely refreshing to have. And you know, the guys are on board and have been really looking forward to all of this and taking it by kind of by the reins and taking everything that those two have to offer in and doing what it takes to be a better team.
Anders, you're a really interesting guy, as we saw right there on the board, 6th-round pick of the Islanders. There were a lot of whispers. I watched you at Edina High School after St. Thomas, obviously, and there was always whispers of the skating isn't good enough. You've scored 74 goals in the last two seasons.
It's good
40,
enough.
40
it's
last
good enough.
Year and 34
yeah.
the year before. It's obviously good enough.
Yeah.
But talk to some of the young players out there about how did you deal with something like that? I've never really seen it bother you. You're a guy that comes to work every day and puts on his work boots. But how have you personally handled that?
Yeah, I think growing up and, you know, when those things were going on and it's your draft year, you're trying to get recruited for college and, you know, all people seem to talk about is, you know, your skating or where you're lacking. But, you know, as a young kid, you feel like you're producing, you're doing all the right things. But, you know, things might not look as pretty skating as other people, but if you get the job done, I think that's all that really matters. And you know, you can battle through any adversity as long as you believe in yourself and you put the work in, and you kind of stick to who you are as a player.
All right, the last captain of the Islanders went into his final season with the team as a potential unrestricted free agent. We know how that played out.
Spicy.
You are now the captain of the Islanders. You are in the final year of your contract. Obviously, you're not going to announce anything on our show here today, although if you'd like to, feel free. But my question is this. You get named. Lou Lamoriello has been around the block. They're part of that group that names you captain. I got to think that you are working towards staying there. How do you feel about the future for you as part of the New York Islanders?
Well, for me, it's just been such an honor to be a part of the Islanders for this long. It's become my home. It's where I've played and grown into myself a little bit, and I love it here. And you know, to have the faith from Lou and Barry and the organization and me to put me as captain, it's such an honor. And I'm looking forward to the future and to things that are going to come. And you know, the contract stuff, those are going to work itself out. You know, it's all good things right now, and you know, good things are going to come as well. But right now, it is kind of what it is, and we're going to worry about, you know, the games and the season and Nashville tomorrow.
All right. That sounds like a good thing for Islander fans. I want to give you one more before I let you go. This year, you're playing Nassau Coliseum and also at Barclays Center. Is that good for the players on the Islanders, yes or no?
Yes, it is. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, we all live out here on the island. You know, we're close to where we practice, we're close to the Coliseum. And there's so much electricity when you play a game at the Coliseum. You know, my rookie year was the last year there, and it was a special year the way we closed it out. And, you know, it's going to be exciting to reopen it up again this year. We got a few more games at Barclays, which is exciting as well. But for sure that we're, as players, looking forward to getting back to the Coliseum.
All right, Anders, thanks so much for your time today. Congratulations on being named captain of the Islanders. Congratulations on the win last night, and all the best during the season. We'll be talking to you down the road.
I appreciate it, guys. Thanks for having me.